Hi everyone, this is Prashant Parthivan again. So my second video is going to be more about homeowners insurance, basics about homeowners insurance. Again, I'll try to cover at a high level so that everyone gets to know basics of homeowners insurance. To start with, right, like why do we need a homeowners insurance? As a homeowner, if something happens to my home, I need some kind of risk management strategy so that I am in the safe place. So that's the reason why homeowners will need homeowners insurance. So there could be different categories of homeowners who will need homeowners insurance. The first category will be people who stay in single family home, where there are common structures and the dwelling and all other attributes. Similarly, the second category could be people who rent apartments or other homes. Third category could be people who stay in town homes, where the common areas are owned by HOA and the dwelling and the inside areas are owned by the unit owners. So all these three category people, they may need homeowners insurance to take care of the risk management issues. Now, in homeowners, we have three broad categories of forms. One is a basic form, one is a broad, one is a special. You can correlate this equal to a phone, right? If you have a Nokia phone, that's a basic one, which has minimal features. Say if you take Motorola, which is a little bit advanced from Nokia, and if you take iPhone or Samsung, which is the latest, which has all the features and functionalities. But the common purpose is the same for all the three phones, right? Similar to that, in insurance also, all these three forms are going to cover us, but the only difference is the amount of coverage it is going to give us. If you take basic form, it's going to cover 11 perils. Perils is nothing but cause of loss like fire, water leakage, or vandalism or theft. So similarly, there are listed 11 perils which will cover under basic form. And if it's broad form, 16 perils. Say like if there are any falling objects that have hindered your home, which will be under broad form. It will not be covered under basic form. If there is any water leakage in the basement, that will come under basic form. So, coming to special form, that's a very good form which will have a higher premium. It's all risk coverage. That means anything that happens to your home will be covered until otherwise it's excluded. So, that is called as special form. So, coming to the structure, right? Because if you go to your homeowner's contract document, there will be a structure which will detail the coverages given to you or your family. To start with, your homeowner's policy, the first document or first page will be declaration page. Declaration page will exactly say who is insured and what is the policy period for which you have the policy and what is the coverage amount, and all those basic details will be there in the declaration page. The agreement and definition is nothing but the agreement between you and the insurer, plus the definitions are going to have unique words that are specific to property and casualty insurance so that there is no ambiguity in your policy document. There are two kinds of coverages. One is the property coverage, which is going to cover your home, your personal property and other structures. The second one is the liability coverage. Liability coverage is nothing but if in case if there is any damage to your neighbor or someone else due to your negligence, that will be covered under liability coverage. To start with property coverage, the first coverage that you will see in your document is dwelling coverage. Dwelling coverage is nothing but the coverage that is given to your dwelling, that's your home, in case something happens to it. So, don't mistake your dwelling coverage with your total home value. Dwelling coverage is nothing but the amount it takes for the insurance company to rebuild the home to the original state or whatever it may be. So, that is what called as dwelling coverage. I will come to the exact calculation, how they calculate in the second page. Other structures, right? So, dwelling coverage will take care of any coverage that is part of your dwelling. It could be garage, which will be part of dwelling coverage because it is attached to your dwelling. If you have a swimming pool, which is not attached to your dwelling, if you have a shed, which is not attached to your dwelling, those will be covered under other structures. The best practice is, if you have a dwelling coverage for 400K, it is 10% of 400K. It's like 40K will be a coverage amount for other structures. Personal property. Like personal property could be anything that you have in your home, your TV, your fridge, your refrigerator, or anything that you have. So the coverage will be 50% of the original dwelling coverage. So one thing that you need to know about personal property is, it is not required that your personal property needs to be in your home. say you take your personal property to play golf or you take it outside of your home, still the coverage will be given for your personal property. Loss of use. Say you have a home where you stay there, if something happens to your home and your insurance company working to rebuild it, during that time you need some place to stay, right? So you have to rent a home or you have to stay in a hotel. So those coverages will be taken care under loss of use. So in case if you are not able to use your property, you can use this coverage to for the temporary purpose. Additional coverages. On top of these coverages, like no, if they, you have a plants which are outside your dwelling, so those will be covered under additional coverages. Exclusions, conditions. So by default, every policy will have some kind of exclusions. As a homeowner, it's very, very important for you to go through the document very clearly so that you know what are excluded, what are included. Conditions, right? So every insurer wants to make sure that you as an insurer insured satisfy some conditions. Say like if you have a deductible, it is your responsibility to pay your deductible. Deductible is nothing but if in case of claim, its insurer has to pay some amount, like say 500 or 1000, before the insurance company starts paying. So if you have a claim, you have to report the claim within 30 days. So those are the conditions that are documented in the condition section. If in case if the insurer does not follow the condition, the claim may be rejected. So it's very important as an homeowner, you go through the conditions in a detailed manner. Endorsements, right? So basic is basic policy have all the coverages. Your home could be a little bit unique, so that you could need some kind of, you know, special endorsement. One example is, say if your personal property is covered under 50%, if you have unique properties like jewels or some other thing that you have to have additional coverages or additional amounts, so you can use endorsements so that those additional unique items can be covered. So this is all the structure of the property when it comes to property coverage. Coming to liability coverage, as I clearly mentioned, liability is not for you, it is for your neighbors who are impacted by your negligence or something that happens to them or their own property due to your negligence. Say you have a tree or you have something that is outside your home in fill and it impacted your neighbor's, you know, patio. So what will happen is you can access this liability coverage and make a payment to your neighbor. Similarly, medical payment. Say you have your neighbor or your neighbor's kids who are playing in your home and mistakenly they fell and they impacted their hand or, you know, whatever the happens to them. So you can access this medical payment so that proper treatment can be given to them. Similar to property coverages, we have the same thing: additional coverages, exclusions, conditions, exclusions, conditions, and endorsements. It is so similar to property, we do have additional areas that are specific to the liability coverages. Coming to the next section is loss evaluation. As I told you, when you determine your dwelling coverage, you have to have a method to calculate the amount required to rebuild the home. So there are two ways you can do that. One is the replacement cost, one is the actual cash value. So the replacement cost is, say you have a home, you stay there for 10 years, something happens. So what the insurance company will do is, they will calculate in such a way that how much money it will take to rebuild the home as if it is a new home, because if they have to buy the cement, they have to buy all the required items. That is a replacement cost. And actual cash value is, you are staying in that home for 10 years. So there is a depreciation down the line, right? So the depreciation will be taken into account so that the dwelling amount will be accordingly calculated. So the difference here is, for replacement cost coverage, the premium will be high, but when it comes to actual cash value, the premium will be low because the depreciation is taken into account. Again, this is a very short video, but once you get into detail, you'll understand more. So coming to the types of policies, right? Like, you know, we, as I told you, we have single family homes, we have condominiums, we have renters. So for every kind of people, insurance companies have different types of policies. To start with the HO2. This is nothing but the broad form, as I told you. It has 16 perils, and also this is covered under the replacement cost basis. The second one is a special form, which is nothing but all risk coverage. So when I say all risk coverage, as I told you clearly, anything that happens to your home, it could be no lightning or it could be theft, it will be covered. Again, the only caveat here is, the HO3, the building and the other structures. Building and the other structures will be covered under all risk, but when it comes to personal property, it will be like no named perils. So only the listed perils will be covered. If something happens to your personal property due to theft, it will be covered. So only the listed perils are going to be covered under special form. Content form. This is for those who rent a home, like I am as a unit owner or I'm going to stay in a rental home. So what happens is I will not need dwelling coverage or I will not need other structures. All that I need is coverage for my personal properties. In those cases, you have to select HO4 form where I don't need coverage for my dwelling itself. Only I need coverage for the personal property. The HO5, this is a very comprehensive form. The difference between HO5 and HO3 is, here as I mentioned, the special form is covered under replacement cost for dwelling and other structures, but it's not covered for personal property. But in case of comprehensive form, my dwelling, other structures, or and the personal properties, everything will be covered under replacement cost. This is the very detailed policy, but the premium will be a little bit higher. Unit owner's form. This is for those who stay in condominiums or townhomes. Because as I told you, the external common areas will be taken care by the HOA. So anything that is needed for within your building, those coverages will be covered under HO6 forms. HO8, we have encountered a scenario where there will be a home which was built like 100 years back. But when you want to rebuild that homes now, even though the cost is less, but since the kind of items that we need to rebuild is going to be unique, so the coverages will be different. So those kind of people has to go to HO8, where the kind of building artifacts are very older and it's not available in the current generation. So now coming to the factors that are determining the premium, right? So we have our home, we need to calculate the premium, right? So the major factors that you take into account are for calculating the premium is dwelling location, right? So where is the location? Like, you know, is it in the place where there is more flood, or is it in the place where it is safe location? So your location is going to be one of the critical factors to calculate the premium. Second one is public protection class. So they derive these classes based on where the exact location is. Say you have your home where it's like 2 minutes from the fire station. So that means your public protection class could be in such a way that your premium is less. If you have your home where your fire engine or no fire station is like 20 minutes away, that means your premium will be high. So that is what is called a public protection class. Based on your safety of your home, this will be calculated. Same thing here, construction factors. What are the kind of construction factors that are used? Like what are the cements that are used? So those also will be taken into these factors, construction factors. Coverage amount, right? So how much amount of coverage we need? Is it like the entire coverage, or it's based on the replacement cost or actual cash value? Your premium may differ. Policy form, what kind of form you select? Is it a broad form or basic form or special form? Based on that, your premium could differ. This is all how you calculate your base premium. Once you calculate your base premium, you have to do some kind of adjustment. Say I am a unit owner, I need a specific endorsement that are applicable to my home. So I will select my endorsements. So once I select my endorsements, on top of it, say I have a deductible, common deductible is $1,000. In case there is a claim, I am responsible to pay $1,000. But I would like to pay $5,000 in case something happens. So my premium will be less. So deductible changes also is going to be a critical factor to come up with your base premium adjustments. Unusual construction types. If my home is a very unique home which needs a lot of rebuilding factors, then that also will be one of the factors for base premium adjustments. Finally, the final adjustments, right? So unit owners may have n number of claims in the last 1 or 2 years. So that means their history is very bad. So in those scenarios, the premium will be more. So the claim history is also going to be another factor. Insurance score, like a credit score, every unit owner having something like insurance score, which will tell how good they were when they were maintaining their homes. So those also will be one of the factors to calculate the premium. Package policy, right? So you have homeowners. Similarly, what will happen is you may take personal auto policy under the same insurance company. So you will have some kind of credits. So that is also one of the factors to calculate the premium. Taking all those factors into account, we come up with your final premium. So these are the high level inputs that I would like to give. As I told you, I am not an insurance agent. I am just giving you a high level overview about your homeowner's policy. If you have any specific questions about your own insurance, you need to contact your insurance agent. This is just meant for high level overview about insurance, homeowners insurance. Again, thank you so much for your time. Take care. Bye bye.